baby, our baby, Satan's baby!
There are things in heaven and on earth beyond the comprehension of man. Call them what you will. The occult, witchcraft, devil worship.
Satan, behold thy supplicants!
Arise and come in, child. Enter for yet another lifetime in the Brotherhood of Satan.
The Brotherhood of Satan. A demon spirit of madness and murder holds a California town in the grip of terror.
My God, they're all mad.
Witches. Black artisans, celebrants of the Black Mass.
A story of contemporary family witchcraft in California. The Brotherhood of Satan, rated GB.
He made them become his slaves, to worship his unholy deeds, to love the devil. Lucifer's Women.
Suppose that there was a man who could make you do whatever he wanted you to.
I want a life. We need a pure soul. She'll do.
He wants to ball you. He really does. He thinks I should persuade you.
One by one, they fall under his power, entranced by the Prince of Darkness and his evil world.
I've exorcised him. It worked. It worked.
I must pass on to another incarnation. You must make her kill me. And then herself, at the moment of orgasm. That's how it must be.
Their minds controlled by an agonizing torment. Their desires must be fulfilled by the darkest satanic acts of incredible and shocking horror. Lucifer's Women. You'll meet those who cannot be exorcised, as they are possessed by evil and driven to unspeakable acts of wanton and hideous cruelty. You'll never forget Lucifer's Women, a new dimension in exorcism and terror. Lucifer's Women, from Constellation Films, rated R for adults.
Don't look right. You are up. We were hoping you'd sleep a bit longer.
Where am I?
This is Pleasant Hill Hospital. You don't remember coming here last night?
No. The last thing I remember was falling asleep at General Hospital.
Let's not worry about that, my dear. Dr. Spector will explain it all
to you. Dr. Spector?
You'll meet him later.
But who's Dr. Spector?
He's in charge of the hospital. He's your doctor.
Dr. Nolan is my doctor. Did he bring me here last night?
I don't have that information.
Well, then can you tell me who does? Because there's been some mistake. I have no idea what's happened. I'd like you to call Dr. Nolan for me. I can't understand how something like this could possibly happen. And I know Dr. Nolan wouldn't permit such a thing. I guess hospitals just aren't as organized as they're supposed to be. I'd like you to call Dr. Nolan for me so I could get this whole thing straightened out.
Miss Martin, your doctor sent you to this hospital because he is confident that Dr. Spector can bring you back to health.
What are you talking about? I don't know any Dr. Spector. I don't know him. I don't know you. And furthermore, you can't keep me here.
You must speak only when asked to do so. Dr. Spector is a great man, but not a weak one. This hospital is under strict rules. Disobedience of those rules will be dealt with severely.
I'm going to see Dr. Nolan.
I'm sorry to do this.
Let go of me. What
are you doing? You must demand peace and quiet.
No,
you must think of the other patients. A few more hours,
stop
rest, Miss Martin, and you'll
let
be fine.
Go of
and
me.
Then Dr. Spector will be able to see you.
Let go of. No, no. 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 Don't do that. I want to see Dr. I want Dr. Oh. No, right.
Thank you. Really now, Miss Martin, you're going to have to stop all this yelling and screaming. You'll disturb the other patients.
Why don't those people out there hear me?
People? No, there's no one out there, Miss Martin.
Don't tell me that. I know they're not there now, but they were a minute ago.
Well, let's not worry about it. Besides, we can't have you looking like this in front of the others.
I want to see Dr. Spector.
Well, I'm afraid Dr. Spector is out for the evening. But I'm sure he'll see you first thing in the morning. Come on now, freshen up a bit and I'll take you down to dinner.
I'm not hungry. Why have I been locked in my room? I want to know why I've been locked in my room.
I believe you'll find a brush in the drawer.
There was a woman who came in here early and she locked me in my room.
Oh, you must mean Martine. She's Dr. Spector's assistant.
She doesn't make a very good impression.
Well, you'll get used to her. She was just following instructions. Ah, oh, that's much better. Come on.
I have to put my shoes on first.
Your table's over there.
You're new here, aren't you?
Yes.
Forgive my friends. We don't often have new people eat with us. They always seem to sit at the other tables.
Do you know who those people are at the other table?
I don't know. I've never been close enough to them to find out.
Do you suppose it...
I wish you could speak, poor devil. It must be frustrating.
How long have you been here?
I came here a few weeks ago. The other two were here before me. He's been here longer than any of us.
Dr. Spector says that he'll be able to restore my sight very soon.
Oh, Dr. Spector is really a very remarkable man. Why, he even promised me that I would walk out of here. I've been confined to this chair for 20 years. I've seen every major specialist in the country. When I first heard of Dr. Spector, I'd given up. But he offered me such hope.
Do you believe it can perform miracles?
Call it what you want, but if there's a chance, we have to take it.
What do you know about those people over there?
Nothing. We don't ask. It's simpler that way. What is our Dr. Spector going to do for you?
That's become the joke of the day because I don't even know Dr. Spector, and yet suddenly I'm told I'm his patient. It's very confusing because, well, the last thing I remember was falling asleep at General Hospital. The next thing I knew, I woke up in this place.
Don't worry. Dr. Spector knows what's best for you. You just do as he says, and everything will be fine.
Why are we served a full meal and those people only given an egg?
There's one thing you'll have to learn, and that is not to question anything that is done around here. You mind your business and they'll mind theirs. Believe me, it's the best way.
I'm sorry, but I just can't accept things the way you do. I mean, I don't even know why I'm here, so I can hardly afford to mind my own business.
Thank you.
suppose you shouldn't leave a dinner table like that. We were wondering where you went. The food isn't that bad, is it? Now, unless you want a broom. We'll go back to the dining room.
I heard voices in there.
Come on. All I know.
As soon as I could. Have you been to see Lucina today? Transfer? Where to? Why would Dr. Nolan transfer to another hospital? What? Well, you have any idea how to get there? Yeah.
At last, Miss Martin, I've enjoyed your concert.
Thank you.
Welcome to Pleasant Hill. Are you comfortable?
Well, Doctor, I've been trying to tell everyone in this place that there's been a very serious mistake. Now, for one thing, I don't understand
why... There'll be time for all your questions later. May I offer you some water?
No, thank you.
Dr. Nolan and I have discussed your case in great depth. Your breakdown was a minor
breakdown?
One,
breakdown? Dr. Nolan never mentioned anything to me about a breakdown. He gave me the impression that all I needed was a little rest. That's why I went to the hospital in the first place. I'm sorry, but I'm sure Dr. Nolan has never mentioned your name to me.
Nolan didn't want to alarm you. He thought that I might explain it best.
nothing to explain. Look, Doctor, I was living a perfectly normal life, and then suddenly, for no reason that makes any sense to me, I find myself in this place, among strange people, experiencing terrifying things. Nightmares.
You've been shocked by a sudden change of environment. You'll overcome it, and in no time at all, you'll be back resuming your career. You know, Miss Martin, I'm a great admirer of yours. I've attended as many of your concerts as my time and work would allow.
Doctor, if you don't mind, I didn't sleep very much last night, and I'm very tired. Now, the only thing I want to hear about or discuss is my immediate release.
Sit down. Please. Forgive me. I'm tired. Work long past due. Late hours.
I would like to know what you intend to do about this, Doctor. I do have a right to know.
Of course. But I have to examine you before discussing your condition.
Examine me? Doctor, there's nothing wrong with me. I told you that before. I'm perfectly normal. Let me tell you something. If I could survive the last few hours and keep my sanity, I know nothing is wrong with me.
The examination is purely routine, Miss Martin. But we can't help you without it.
All right.
Now, if you remove your clothing and wrap this sheet around you, I'll be back in a moment. Nurse?
Bath is ready, my dear.
I don't like my bath that hot.
Dr. Spector ordered a hot bath. I do think we should follow his instructions.
How long do I have to stay in?
Not long, just what is required.
Oh, come on, you think that's hot enough?
Wash your back for you.
That's okay, I can do it.
No, I'll help you. Ah, your skin is lovely, Miss Martin. So soft, so white, almost as if it were unblemished by sin.
Thank you.
I was beginning to wonder if there was anyone here.
May I help you, sir?
Yes, it's Sunday. You know, visiting hours. I'm here to see Lucinia Martin.
Well, I'm afraid we don't have visiting hours at this hospital, not on Sundays or any other day. If you'd care to make an appointment.
What are you talking about?
There is nothing else.
Hey, now, wait a minute, damn it. You're going to answer a few questions for me before you start slamming doors in my face. Now, is Lucinia here? I ask you a question.
Perhaps I could help you, young man.
Who are you?
I'm Dr. Spector, director of the hospital.
Maybe you can. Your friend here says that you don't have visiting hours. What kind of a hospital is it that doesn't have visiting hours?
Whom did you wish to see?
My fiancée, Lucinia Martin.
I see Mr.
Duncan, Chris Duncan.
Mr. Duncan, it's not that we don't have visiting hours here at Pleasant Hill. It's just that this is an asylum and some of our patients are easily disturbed. I gave instructions that no one was allowed to see Lucinia at this time.
And why not?
Well, I felt it would be better for Lucinia if her treatment was not interrupted at this stage. You wouldn't want her to have a relapse, would you?
A relapse? A relapse from what? There's nothing wrong with her.
Don't you think that decision's best left to her doctor? Now, if you'll excuse me, I'll get back to my patient.
Hey! Damn you!
Chris.
I thought it was better at this time that you not have any reminder of the outside world for the moment, at least. The treatment we have you on might not be effective if we clutter it up with memories. We have to keep thinking of tomorrow, don't we?
But when will Chris be back? What did he say? Anything?
He's very understanding. He said to tell you he sends his love, and I told him to keep in touch with me, and I tell him when you could receive visitors.
When will that be, Doctor?
If you're good, do as you're told. That should be soon. But you must cooperate with me, or we're both wasting our time. I want to release you as much as you want to go. Now, go to your room. And don't worry. Mr. Duncan is most anxious that you cooperate with us. He knows we're doing everything for your good.
Mr. Nolan and Mr. Chris Duncan is here to see you.
Please sit down, Mr. Duncan.
I'm sorry to ask to see you without an appointment, Doctor, but I feel this is an urgent matter.
Urgent matter?
I just found out that Lucine has been transferred to another hospital. Now, I had no idea she was that serious. And after my visit to that asylum yesterday, well, I'm really very concerned.
Asylum? There's nothing really wrong with Lucinia, except that she's overworked. I told her a year ago she should slow down. Perhaps even take a short vacation. She seemed to think that was out of the question. But an asylum, surely you must be mistaken.
I'm not mistaken, Doctor. She's in some place called Pleasant Hill, and I don't know why. Well, she was perfectly healthy when we came back from the mountains last weekend. But now suddenly she's in this Pleasant Hill Asylum or Sanitarium or whatever the hell it is, and I don't understand it. Who's this Dr. Spector that you've called in on the case?
That wasn't my decision, unfortunately. Actually, I've not met the man. The day after I brought Lucinia into the hospital, I got a telegram instructing us to transfer her to Pleasant Hill for special treatment.
Who sent that telegram?
Her father. We don't usually do things like this, but he called the following day insisting that his instructions be followed to the letter. He was so insistent, I really had no choice. He said that all arrangements had been made and she should be transferred right away.
Are you sure it was her father?
Yes. Why do you ask?
Because, Doctor, her father died when she was 12 years old.
Are you sure her father's dead? She never told me. But then she's only been under my care a short while.
I'm absolutely positive. Now, what do you know about Dr. Spector?
Not much, I'm afraid. His name appeared a few times in the medical journal several years ago. If I'm not mistaken, he established an excellent reputation in the physiology of pain and pain reflexes, particularly in the biochemical reaction of pain in the central nervous system. He wrote several articles and impressed a great many doctors.
Well, how long ago was this?
Oh, about 10, 15 years ago at least. But I could find out.
No, that's not necessary. Have you heard anything about him or his work since then?
No, I don't remember hearing anything lately. He seemed to have disappeared. I thought perhaps he had retired from the medical profession. To be perfectly frank, I was shocked myself when I saw his name on the telegram. He was in his 70s when those articles appeared.
70? That's impossible.
No, I'm sure he was in his 70s when he was working on the pain experiment.
Could there be two Spectors? Because the man I saw yesterday couldn't have been more than 45. Yet from what you say, he'd have to be at least 80 years old.
All I know is what I've told you.
That still leaves me with a lot of unanswered questions. But thank you anyway.
I wish I could have been more helpful to you.
No, I understand.
Please keep me informed. I'll do all that I can to help.
Right.
Dr. Spector said this would be my final treatment. I've waited so long for this day. Where are all the fancy machines Dr. Spector was talking about? What do you think you're doing?
Yes, ma'am, I know you've already told me that. Yes, I'll do what I can.
Yes, ma'am, I understand. Yes. Yes, ma'am.
Are you Welsh?
Just soon I get a chance to come out. Yeah. Yeah. I told you I do what I can. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Okay, fine. Fine. Yes, yes, ma'am.
I'm looking for Detective Walsh.
I'm Walsh.
I'm Chris Duncan. I think I'm here to report a kidnapping.
All right, Mr. Duncan, who's been kidnapped?
Well, I'm not certain she's been kidnapped.
Wait, wait, wait. Who is she?
Lucinia Martin.
Spell Lucinia.
L-U-C-I-N-A.
Girlfriend?
Fiancé.
All right, you're not sure she's been kidnapped, but what?
Well, it's just kind of hard to explain. I don't really know where to start.
How about the beginning, okay?
All right. Have you ever heard of a place called the Pleasant Hill Hospital?
Pleasant Hill? No.
Well, Lucinia was admitted there a few days ago, but they don't allow anyone to see it.
So what's so strange about that? Look, lots of times they won't let a patient have visitors. And you say she was admitted, so how do you get a kidnap charge out of that? Forget it, Mr. Duncan. Unless you have more facts than you've already given me, I don't have a reason to even begin an investigation.
There are more facts. There's a hell of a lot more facts. Something wrong with that whole damn place. You feel it. The minute you enter the gates, you feel it.
Surely you don't expect us to go out here and raid a place simply because someone has a strange feeling about it. Come on, Mr. Duncan. We'd be raiding every church and funeral parlor in town if we used that philosophy.
Look, all I'm asking you to do is to come out there with me and take a look for yourself. Somehow I just don't think your damn time's that valuable.
Look, you don't come into my office telling me how to rot. All right, I'll take you out to your Pleasant Hill. I want you to see just how ridiculous you really look. You were here last.
I was here yesterday, and this gate was open.
Looks to me like it hasn't been open in 20 years.
You know, Duncan, you said you had a strange feeling. Now I have one. I have a strange feeling you want to play haunted house.
Look, you're this far. You may as well walk to the top of the hill.
This is the land of Oz, and you're the wizard. And what a day. First you, now the stream. I suppose this place was all neat and trim yesterday.
Oh, what do you think I do, Walsh? Just run from town to town lying to you cops?
I was wondering about that.
Yesterday, this place was alive with people, I swear it!
You know, when I write my book, you're going to be chapter one. Come on, I've seen enough.
I'm not going to. I see Dr. Spector.
You know, your trouble is that you've seen too many specters already. If you want to see your phantom doctor, you walk back to town.
Ain't nobody going to answer that door, young man. This place has been closed for years.
Can we go now?
No. No, this man is Dr. Spector.
Sure. Sure he is.
Name's Spaulding. Been the caretaker here for years. Ain't no Dr. Spector around here, though. You fellas better get.
What are you talking about? Your name is Dr. Spector. You run this hospital. Now, where's Lucinia?
Now, mister, you're wrong. This here ain't no hospital.
Look, he claims his fiancée was admitted to this hospital. House was a patient.
Well, you can see, mister, ain't been nobody here for years.
Well, this is going to look great on my report. Visited a haunted house looking for a doctor named Spector. Come on.
Where's Lucinia? What have you done with her? Oh!
You are, Grayson. I want that man arrested. That sheriff's spot is probably. And he's trying to kill me.
That's Dr. Spector!
You
to come downtown if you want to find a farmer.
I will. Get him out of here before I take care of him myself.
Thank you.
Operator. Operator, hello? Operator? Oh, God, please answer. Didn't you sleep well?
What's upstairs?
More patients? More rooms?
I went up there last night.
That's impossible, my dear. I checked on you several times. You were sleeping soundly.
But I remember it so clearly. Dr. Spector, they were all there!
You must have been dreaming. There's no dead body on the third floor. I promise. It was your imagination. You've been very tense since you've arrived here. You know, Miss Martin, if you don't get some rest, Dr. Spector can't help you. Relax, my dear. You're working yourself up over nothing.
Thank you. reckon that old man didn't come in to fire a plate, so there's no sense in me holding you any longer.
It's awful damn nice of you. You don't believe me at all about that place, do you?
Look, I know what I saw, and it's not what you said it was. Anyway, there's nothing I can do without some kind of evidence to back up your story. Look, I don't mind trying to help people out because it's my job. But taking everything into consideration, there's no way I can justify any action to myself or my boss. So unless you have something more positive...
Oh, Walsh, you're the true public servant.
You know, there are three elements about this case that confuse me. You come to me with a hospital I can't find, and a doctor that nobody knows, and a kidnapped girl who doesn't exist. Go get a lad's lamp and make your three wishes come true. Then we can talk. Until...
Tom Walsh. Look, I want you to do me a favor. You saw the kid I just let go that... Yeah, Duncan, yeah. Yeah, sounds like you read my report. Look, I don't think there's anything to the story he gave me, right? No, well, I mean, it doesn't hold water. But the kid's so damn sincere, I want to find out something. You know, just my own curiosity. How about running a routine check for me, will you? Yeah, just find out. Just the particulars, right? You've got it in the... Pleasant Hill, yeah. No, it was completely deserted. Yeah, I know it. I know it. How was I to know before I got there? Yeah, and the doctor, yeah. Jason Spector, yeah. No, I never heard of him either, but... Look, don't spend any time on it. Just a routine check, will you? See what you come up with. Let me know, will you, Ed? Okay. Okay, bye. Thanks.
Miss Martin, doctor.
I understand you had a rather rough night last night.
Just a nightmare, I guess.
Nothing uncommon, and nothing to worry about. Actually, I feel you've made remarkable progress. I'm confident that with a little self-discipline, you'll be just fine. So, I've decided that after this last treatment this evening, I'm going to turn you over to Dr. Nolan's care.
Does that mean I can leave tomorrow morning?
Well, if you respond to the treatment as well as I feel you will, I see no reason why you can't leave in the morning.
What kind of treatment did you have in mind, Doctor?
Nothing complicated. I've called Mr. Duncan. He'll be here to reassure you.
Chris?
Yes, he called earlier today, and I told him what time he could come by and pick you up in the morning. So, you can look forward to resuming your musical career. You know, I'd much rather see you in front of an orchestra than in front of my desk. However, you must promise not to push yourself.
I promise.
Good. I'll see you tonight, then.
You will.
Thank you.
Yes, I'll visit.
Where the hell did you get?
At the hospital. Now, is that enough evidence? God, is that enough evidence?
Not if your doctor died 20 years ago.
Oh, what do you mean?
He'd been doing some checking on your Dr. Spector. He was picked up several times for devil worshipping. Couldn't prove anything on that, but he was suspected of murder.
Oh, God!
One of the victims found in the doctor's office.
What happened to her?
That's one of those unanswered questions. He was never brought to trial. He died before they caught him.
Died? You don't suppose there could be any connection between the picture and that?
I don't know.
Oh, you mentioned devil worshiping.
Yeah, but we can't go around arresting people for that nowadays.
I'm not asking for an arrest. All I want you to do is search that place.
All right, we'll have to wait till morning to get a search warrant.
The hell we will. Listen to me. You wake up the judge, or whoever it is in this town that makes out search warrants, and you get it tonight. Spector, Spaulding, or whatever he calls himself, could kill the senior before morning. Let's go.
We are about to meet again, Master. I have kept our pact these many years. The mute was burned. The blind girl was given to the reptiles and beheaded. Cripple was fed to the insects. Now, Master, you will soon have your sacrifice.
What's the matter?
She bit me. Well, it's been quite a struggle. But don't worry. Everything's been prepared, and Miss Martin is being ready now.
Good. My time's running out. Bring Miss Martin down immediately. I'll join you in a few moments. I must get Martine.
Are you all right?
I'm all right. I just haven't much longer. Now, hurry.
Yes, sir.
I must make it. I must.
Thank you. Satan, Lord and Archdemon of Infinite, I call upon the gates of the dark realm to crash asunder, that my commands may ride upon the winds of the abyss. O herald of hell, behold, I speak the keys of the nine angels, and I summon the demon who hath leased the apocalypse, Abaddon, Titan, master of the seven, whose name is and shall be Death. Through the blazing angles of the shining trapezoid, for by the tenth key, thy doom hath been spoken. For we are alike, true worship of the highest and ineffable King of Hell. Thy rights have been spoken. Met are thy terms by Acridian, fire, serpent, dismemberment. Loose the hounds from the barrier and come among us, for the bond of Satan hath been sealed. By Asmodeus, Belial, and Leviathan, arise, move, appear, leave thy burned and darkened castle beyond the stars, and behold, the goat without horns, untouched, unblemished according to thy desire, and by thy covenant, cleansed in the black fire. Show the mystery of thy creation! Ave Satanis, Rege Satanis, Hail Satan! My master pleased with his virgin sacrifice? Take it in exchange for my continued eternal life.
Shall we proceed? What is it? Please, Master.
Examined her myself. I have not deceived you. Your desires have been fulfilled. The sacrifices you asked of me are done, Master. And the supreme sacrifice now lies before you. But Master, she has been watched. She's been examined every day since she's been here. I have not deceived you, Master. Master, please, Master, I have done nothing wrong.
No, Master.
That's it for me, Joe Bob Briggs, reminding you that you are unique, just like everybody else. Did you hear that following the approval of Viagra by Britain's health authorities, the first shipment arrived yesterday at Heathrow Airport? But it was hijacked on the way to the depot, and Scotland Yard has just warned the public to be on the lookout for a gang of hardened criminals. Joe Bob Briggs reminding you that the drive-in will never die. Guy goes to the proctologist for his first examination. And the doctor tells him to have a seat in the examination room, and he'll be right with him. So the guy's sitting there, and he notices that there are three items on the counter there, a tube of KY jelly, a rubber glove, and a beer. When the doctor comes in, the guy says, look, doc, this is my first exam. I know what the KY jelly's for, and I know what the glove is for. What's the beer for? And the doctor gets outraged, and he storms to the door, and he flings the door open, and he yells, dang it, nurse, I said a butt light.